Lucy put on that all look at let us now accompany our dear sister for her last Mass here on earth. It's now time for us to file past and pay our last respect to our dear sister Lucy. As we do this, we also read the tributes.
church. The washrooms are behind the church and in the hall, just in case they are trying to reach a call. We are in the foul pass now. And then we start with the tribute. First one is on the grandchildren. So the grandchildren, please come over and meet your tribute. Grandchildren.
Good morning, everybody. This is a tribute to our amazing grandmother. She is and will always be the best grandmother God gave us. Our biggest cheerleader in everything we did. She would call to check in on our goals. She would go through the ups and downs by our side. She would support us with everything she had. She would inspire us until we felt inspired enough to keep going. Indeed, she was one of a kind. She was sweet, caring, and loving to all of us, her grandchildren. She loved us through and through and was the sweetest. We will sorely miss her carefully drafted text messages and kind words of encouragement that reminded us of how special we were in the eyes of God. We will miss her each day, and she'll forever stay in the deepest parts of our hearts. Thank you, Grandma Lucy, for your love, your support. Your inspiring words and heart. We will love you forever. Rest in peace, knowing that the seeds you planted in our hearts will not go in vain.
We will now take a musical interlude by the keyboardist to wait for the next tribute. Thank you. Now we'll take the tribute by the in-laws. If the person to read is around, please come take that. In-laws, the in-laws. Tribute by the in-laws. Please come and read that. If the in-laws are not available, can we take that of the brothers and sisters? Brothers and sisters. Whoever is reading for the brothers and sisters, please come over and read a tribute.
Tributes by nieces and nephews. 1 Corinthians 13:13. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Our dear Auntie Lucy, you are love personified, ever cheerful, warm, bubbly, and a teaser par excellence. For those of us who are privileged to have known you as our aunt, we count it a true blessing from above. News of your passing came to us as a shock. Many of us are still wondering how this could be true. But our consolation is that we had you in our lives to call aunt. Now your typical words, "I love you," at the end of our phone conversations will remain treasured in our hearts and minds. May the Lord Jesus grant you eternal rest in him. From the children of your brother Justice Laluvi, thank you for being our auntie and always being there to advise us. Your wise counsels continue to ring in our ears. You never stopped reaching out to us and wanting to be a part of our lives. May your gentle and loving soul rest in perfect peace. You are forever in our hearts. From the children of your brother, Paul Chikata, dear Auntie Lucy, it is painful to accept that you are no more with us. However, memories of all the beautiful moments we had with you are entrenched in our hearts. Your genuine love and compassion will be missed. Rest well, Auntie, till we meet again. From the children of your brother, Peter Chikata, you have a guardian angel in heaven watching over us, and it's you, our beloved Auntie Lucy. Thank you for charting a path of good that everyone can follow. We miss you a lot. May you rest in eternal peace. From the children of your sister, Paulina Jani, you are soft-spoken and had kind words for everyone. You always had a smile and endearments for each of us, making us feel ever so special. News of your demise came as a shock, which sent us down memory lane, reminiscing the times you visited and when you visited you occasionally in Swedru during our school break. You were one of our favorite aunties, and we will miss you. We would hold dearly in our hearts all of our childhood memories of the times we spent with you. Fare thee well, Auntie Lucy. From the children of your late sister, Gladys Ahiabu, dear Auntie Lucy, you are a one-of-a-kind auntie to us. We will forever cherish your infectious laughter, smiles, endless joy, prayers of blessings, and unforgettable phone calls on birthdays and similar occasions. Thank you for all of your love. Rest well in the bosom of the Lord Jesus. From the son of your sister, Susie Chikata, faithful and loving auntie you were to me. From my birth till your sudden departure to eternity, always concerned and always available, you were my cheerleader and my chief motivator. Though absent, still loved, ever dear, and will be forever missed, Auntie Lucy. From the children of your siblings, Faustina, Sylvanus, and Mabel Chikata, Auntie Lucy, there was a lot of love in your life. Our lasting memories of you were simple, passionate and caring figure who never waned in her support or love for her nieces and nephews. From you, we have learned the importance of showing love, prayer, and faith in God. May the Lord God give you solace and perfect rest. From the nieces and nephews in Ghana and the diaspora, we knew you as hardworking, humble, and very doting. We knew of your many sacrifices for your children and your ever astute counsel at all times. You will be missed, Makafui Chikata and siblings. A silent thought, a quiet prayer for a special person in God's care. Rest easy, Auntie Lucy. We love you. Your happiness and love will remain in our hearts, Kao Chikata and siblings. Our Auntie Lucy was strong-willed and compassionate about her beliefs. She was a go-getter and will use her prowess in psychology to pursue answers to any questions that eluded her. Despite her feisty nature, she was humble enough to come to the level of all of us, her nieces and nephews, and even stand up for those among us sidelined for unconventional life choices. Rest well with our maker, Auntie. Setome Chikata and siblings. Auntie Lucy always calls to check on me ever since she arrived in the U.S. After every call, she would say, I love you, and I will also reply, I love you too. Auntie Lucy showed me so much love because of her relationship with my late father, Patrick, who gave her all the attention that she deserved when she moved from Swedru to Accra. Auntie, it is my turn to show love to all who mourn you today. Rest in peace, Edem Chikata and siblings. Thank you.
Tribute to Sister Lucy from brothers and sisters. I shall pass through this world but once. Any good, therefore, that I can do, or any kindness that I can show to any human being, let me do it now. Let me not defer or neglect it, for I shall not pass this way again, by vigil. Mrs. Lucy Abla Chikata Adams, you were a warm-hearted, humble, and friendly sister who would always remember most family members' birthday and call heartily to wish them. A smile was always your trademark anytime you met people. Our mother once recounted how, as a baby, you would always put on a beautiful smile, full of contentment, while in your court after a bath. That smile could melt any hardened heart, she said. Your life was quite an interesting one, filled with various twists and turns in Ho, Swedru, Nigeria, Aflao, and finally in USA. Your hard-working nature exhibited itself in all these places. You worked selflessly all your life for the benefit of everyone else except yourself. You hardly ever thought of your own personal comfort. No wonder our uncle, Sru, once put this question to you after the narration of some of your life stories. He asked, "Are you also a Ghanaian woman or someone from another planet? The welfare and advancement of your children and grandchildren became your priority and occupation over the years after you left Swedro. We, your brothers and sisters, were always stunned by some of the less pleasant experiences of your life and were always there to help and support you anytime you called. You were very dear to all of us. It is just too painful to lose you. But who are we to question God? Even while planning your final return to Ghana early last year, the welfare of others, not of yourself, was your primary concern. You sent boxes of gifts ahead to be distributed to your family and friends on your arrival. Unfortunately, this distribution was not to be. Sister, you have played your part faithfully and diligently in life. You have finished the race. With aching hearts, we, your brothers and sisters, bid you farewell. May the angels open heaven's gate for you and lead you to the throne of God, your Creator. Jujolenuti Fafama Edenye.
The choir will now sing "How Sweet the Name of Jesus Sounds," after which we'll be taking tribute by children. Tributes by children. Please stand by.
church, please come over. Take a tribute for the children.
Thank you for coming. The book of Ecclesiastes says, everything has its time. To everything, there is a season. A time for every purpose under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. Tributes by children. Mama, nothing prepared us for your sudden and unexpected departure to eternity in the early hours of Tuesday, March 29th, 2022. Mama Lou, as we affectionately call you, to say that our hearts are terribly broken and we are overwhelmed with grief at your sudden death is an understatement. We are in shock at your passing and have not come to terms with the fact that we will never ever see you again on the face of the earth. Nonetheless, we realize that we are truly blessed and highly favored to have such a God-fearing, resilient, hard-working, caring, and kind-hearted mother like you. Sadly, all we have now are sweet and priceless memories of you, which we will carry in our hearts and cherish till we meet again in the vineyard of the Almighty God. Mama Lou, you lovingly sacrificed and devoted your whole life for the upbringing and training and the progress of your children and even your grandchildren. We live together happily in Aguna Swedru. Typical of your sacrificial self, in 1981, you had to make a hard decision to leave us with our late father, Augustus Kweku Adams, and join thousands of Ghanaian teachers who relocated to Nigeria. This was a difficult but necessary choice in your quest to seek more economic empowerment to enable you to take care of the financial demands involved in our upbringing and progress. Your leaving was indeed a sad turning point in our lives. Your absence created a huge vacuum in our lives growing up. Nonetheless, by God's grace, you worked tirelessly in Nigeria. To provide our needs back home, thereby making our lives comfortable, even during the economically challenging times in Ghana. After all your sacrifices and teaching in Nigeria for 10 years, you returned to Ghana with the help of your late sister, Mrs. Gladys Ahiabu, the then Director of Education, Ketu District, and settled in Aflawu. You were appointed the headmistress of SS Peter and Paul Primary and JSS. The joy of having you back with us in Ghana was beyond words. Though we were all a bit grown then and in various educational institutions all over the country, we couldn't wait to spend every holiday with you to enjoy the full benefits of your care, your love, your food, and devotion to us, your children. In April 2001, again, typical of your sacrificial and dedicated nature to the welfare of your children, you took a six-month leave from work and traveled to help our sister Esther in Atlanta, Georgia in the U.S., Atlanta, Georgia in the U.S. Due to unforeseen adverse circumstances, and developments, you had to remain in America for longer than planned, until months turned to years. You sacrificed to stay in the U.S. for years, helping our sister Esther, and looking after your grandchildren. The three siblings in Ghana missed your presence dearly, but maintain constant communication with you on the telephone to fill the void. Mama Lou, one of the many striking characteristics we fondly remember of you is how you particularly made sure we always wrote and spoke English correctly. Our brother Papeson told us a story about how he was so amazed about your reaction to a letter he wrote during his secondary school days when you were away teaching in Nigeria. He was so surprised at how you highlighted all the mistakes in the spellings, the tenses and punctuation in the letter, corrected them all, and resent the letter back to him. Mama, you never ran out of ready and excellent pieces of advice for us, your children, in all aspects and circumstances of our lives. You extended the same to your grandchildren and all categories of persons you came across. You were a source of motivation, encouragement, and inspiration to all. Mama, you always uplifted, encouraged everyone you came across in various situations, especially your grandchildren, your nieces and nephews. They all cherished you so much. Mama Lou, you were blessed with very good health all your life. You were very conscious of your diet and exercise routines. You will be fondly remembered by your neighbors for your trademark of hourly walks that you took every morning throughout your almost 2 decades stay in Atlanta, Georgia. You were a fan of Dr. Oz and readily shared any vital health information you learned on the program with your family and friends. Mama Lou, we really miss you. This short period since you have been gone, your voice has gone silent, and we know we will miss you forever. We are most grateful to God for your life. You were the most courageous, strong, and caring mother we could ever have prayed for. Even in our little, we were the envy of our neighbors, even though you were struggling. At age 75, when you celebrated your birthday, you looked virtually 10 years younger than your age. And everyone who met you or saw your photos could not believe your real age was 75 years. It's against this background that we were so shocked when you first suddenly took ill in July 2021 and had to spend weeks on admission at the hospital. However, our Jehovah Rapha reigned, and you recovered. In December 2021, you celebrated your last Christmas in a very joyous mood with five of your 14 grandchildren surrounding you in Atlanta, Georgia. You kept expressing your profound joy and happiness at how far the Lord has brought them. And they took tons of memorable pictures with you. Little did we know that was going to be the last Christmas. Little did we know that was going to be your last Christmas on earth. Mama, your grandchildren's hearts as they left for school in early January was not supposed to be goodbyes forever. But apparently, God had other plans. And who are we to question the great I am? You were for the past 6 months anxiously waiting for clearance from your doctors to return to Ghana to live with your daughter, Nane Misa, to be close to the family, as well as your other children and grandchildren in Ghana. Mama, your strong desire to return home and celebrate the next Mother's Day in Ghana was so close. But alas, you returned in the least expected way. Life is never going to be the same. Mama, life is never going to be the same without you. Mama Lou, the word of God says in 2 Timothy 7:14, I have fought a good fight. I have finished the race. Finally, there is a laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. Not me only, but all those who loved his appearing. We love you dearly, Mama. Rest well in the bosom of your Redeemer, so we meet again. We love you dearly, Mama. Rest well in the bosom of your Redeemer, so we meet again to part no more. Fare thee well, Mama Lou. Just a biography, I'm sorry, just a tribute that, as some of you know, Mama lived with me in Atlanta, and we had a funeral in Atlanta last Saturday. So this was the biography I wrote. This was the tribute I wrote, so I'm just going to read a bit of it. are my siblings and I, and your grandchildren, your entire family, and many gathered here who loved you dearly are still in shock at your passing. We have still not come to terms with the fact that we will never see you on the face of the earth again. Mama, as I held your hands at the World Star North Fulton Hospital that fateful dawn, watching the numbers on the monitors slowly decrease, indicating that you were taking your last breath, I would have given anything to stop the icy hands of death and giving you your life back. But your Maker, the Creator of the universe, had beckoned you into his glorious home. And who was I to stop you? For those from the room where you were dying, Bernard, your grandchildren's father, had also taken his last breath just 6 weeks earlier. The pain of losing you was piercing and unbearable, and my cries echoed in the entire hospital. If cries from the heart-wrenching pain can bring the dead back to life, you would have been alive, Mama. As I finally gathered myself and left your bedside, my biggest fear was breaking the news of your sudden death to your granddaughters, Mawenam, Penyin, and Kakra, who had told me in a few days earlier, in no uncertain terms, that they could not take you dying barely a month after they had lost their father. How was I going to tell Selikem at home that grandma was never coming back home? Their heart-wrenching cries on hearing about your death cut through my heart like a knife. Life was never going to be the same without grandma at 200 Blessing Way. Mama, we are going to miss you so much. Saturday was Mother's Day, and there was no one for us to wish. Selikem had no one to call her my beautiful one when she walked through the door from school. You were so proud of all your 14 grandchildren, and we are truly grateful that you helped raise them in such a kind, loving, and humble, and made them God-fearing children. We love you dearly, Mama. Fare thee well, till we meet again. We just have a little announcement. Right after Mass, the funeral rite and reception is at Officers' Mess. There's a family burial, private burial at Strong Bay. So we are all staying behind. It's just the body that is going to Strong Bay. All of us are going to the Officers' Mess at 37 to have a reception. And then tomorrow, there is Mass here again, Thanksgiving Mass at 10:30. And then right after Mass, we'll go back to Officers' Mess to finish up Mama Lucy's funeral. So we are pleading with all of you. We thank you for coming this morning, even in the rain. We are very grateful that you beat the rain and came together here to honor our mother. And we are also asking that you please come back tomorrow to finish up with us. God bless you all.
At this time, we are about starting Mass, so let's all get ready while the Mass is about to start.
the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, we gather here this morning to pray for the soul of Lucy Abla Chikata Adams. Before we pray, let us admit our own sins, ask God to be cleansed of all unrighteousness, so that our prayers for Lucy and the sacrifice we offer this morning will be acceptable to God. Let us therefore in silence call to mind our own sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of our Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Let us pray. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Lucy, for whom today we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, she may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated for the readings.
First reading, a reading from the book 2 Corinthians 4:14, 5-1. The things that are seen are transient, but the things that are unseen are eternal. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, we know that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus, and bring us with you in his presence. For it is all for your sake, so that as grace extends to more and more to people, it may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God. So we do not lose heart. Though our outer man is wasting away, our inner man is being renewed every day. For this slight momentary affliction is preparing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, because we look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient, but the things that are unseen are eternal. For we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. The word of the Lord.
Amen. does. Sing it, and then you leave.
Sorry, say that again.
So you can stay here. When you're done singing, you go about, and then you leave.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you also may be. And you know the way where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord. Sometime in August, I think it was 29th of August, Anemisa sent me a message that I should pray for the mother who wasn't well. And I even thought the mother was here. So I was asking where I could visit her, and she said, oh, she's not around. Then later on, she sent another message to say the mother was better, and we were all rejoicing. In that rejoicing, little did we expect that Auntie Lucy was going to go away. Then 2nd of April, Anemisa sends me another message. Father, when can I see you? My mother didn't make it. She left on the 29th of March. Brothers and sisters, Scripture tells us there is time for everything. A time to be born and a time to die. One brings a lot of rejoicing. The other brings a lot of sadness. When a child is born, even enemies rejoice. And when it comes to the time for us to say goodbye to this earth, it is never easy. You tell me, how many times do you think of your own death? We hardly do, because we wish we can push it away farther and farther and farther. But then one day, it comes and we are gone. Auntie Lucy was 78. And even though Scripture will say our lifespan is 70 and 80 for those who are strong, we would have wished he had stayed a little more. So I can understand the tears of the children. But brothers and sisters, on a day like this, we are also aware of the mercies of God. The God who for the past 78 years has been with Lucy through every turn of her life. And we thank God for all the graces and the blessings he bestowed on this world through Lucy. The many people
He used Lucy to bless. Brothers and sisters in Christ, the readings we listened to highlighted one important thing: the fact that death never has the last word. In other words, whether we live or we die, we belong to God. And by the resurrection of Jesus Christ overcomes death, so that death no longer becomes a curse, it becomes a way of joining God in eternity. And that is why when you come for every funeral in the Catholic Church, you see that Paschal candle, which was lighted on Easter Sunday, on Easter Saturday, during the vigil, that on which we write Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, that which represents Christ himself, is always placed at the head of the coffin, symbolizing that we are praying that Jesus, who intercedes for us at the right hand of the Father, should present, in this case, Lucy to God. And we have the crucifix also placed at the other side. So the person who is dead is hemmed between the crucifix and the candle. And all we are saying is that Jesus, take the person, take Lucy, and present her to God the Most High. That is why we are here. To pray for Lucy. Because Jesus tells us in the gospel reading that he has many mansions in the house of his Father. And because he is the way, the truth, and the life, we are all invited to follow Jesus. You know how we sing the song, "I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back." We can't turn our back on Jesus because he is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. And the life he gives us is a life not just for this world, but the life also in eternity. So at the passing of Lucy, we are asking Jesus, who is the way to the Father, to take Lucy to the Father. We're asking Jesus, who is the life of both the living and the dead, to present Lucy to his Father. And for ourselves who gather here this morning, the Word of God reminds us that all we have to do as we sojourn this world is to keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, the author and finisher of the race. If we are taking Jesus serious, Christianity is tough. Anybody who takes Jesus serious knows that to be a good Christian involves a lot of work. But the beauty of this work is that this kind of hard work always pays. So brothers and sisters, remain firm in your faith. Remain firm in your faith. Remain firm in your faith. And may Jesus, who is the way, the truth, and the life, accompany you in all you do. Even as we ask him to take our mother Lucy to the halls of heaven. Amen.
Let us stand. Trusting in the mercy of God, let us present our prayers. Prayers we offer for the peaceful rest of Lucy into the hands of God. We shall respond. In baptism, Lucy was washed clean in the waters of rebirth. May the heavens welcome her into the joys of God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Lucy ate the body of Christ, the bread of life. May she be raised up on the last day. We pray to the Lord. For our diseased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. Let us, in the quiet moments of our hearts, offer a prayer for the peaceful rest of Lucy. May the prayer of those who cry to you benefit the souls of your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, for their sins, and make them sharers in your redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. It's now time for collection. The ushers will direct us.
Sorrow. Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours and the prayers we offer for Lucy may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Lucy, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we might all live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
is Lord. He is Lord. He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, John our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Lucy, from whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in death like this, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who are falling asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us all stand and pray together the prayer our Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we are with the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us one day to life everlasting. It is now time for Holy Communion. Holy Communion is for practicing Catholics who are in the state of grace.
Let us please stand and pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Lucy, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. We shall now take a second collection, and this collection is to support the family. So please let us be very generous.
Yes,
May I invite a member of the family to come forward for the offering. If there are any announcements, we will take them now. After which, we will now listen to the biography of Madame Lucy, and then we'll have the final commendation. Any announcements?
Hi, as we announced initially, the funeral rite is at, the funeral rite is at Officers' Mess at 37. The family has a private burial. So from here, we are taking the body to Strongway for a private burial, but all of us are going to Officers' Mess for a reception. And then tomorrow, we have the Thanksgiving marks here at 10:30. And right after 10:30, we'll go to Officers' Mess to finish up. So thank you all for coming. We truly appreciate it. God bless you for your time, your generous donation. We have a table outside for those who are not able to go to Officers' Mess. We want all of you there. But just in case you are not able, there's a table out there that you could visit. So thank you all so much. God bless you. See you at Officers' Mess.
We shall listen to the biography of Madame Lucy.
Biography of Lucy Abla Chikata Adams. Mrs. Lucy Abla Chikata Adams was born at Adesu near Nsawom on 10th of August 1943 to Mr. James Carnegie Chikata and Madam Christine Ajode Atipu, both of blessed memory. At the time of her birth, her father was the general manager of the Nsawom Adesu branch of UAC, a large trading company in the then Gold Coast. Her mother, Christine Atipo, was a baker and a trader. Lucy spent her childhood in Ho with her elder sister, Emily Babuta Dankudi Chikata. After obtaining her middle school leaving certificate, she proceeded to Peki Teacher Training College and then to St. Francis Teacher Training College at Kokwe, both in the Volta region. Lucy became a devout Catholic and remained so for the rest of her life. At St. Francis, she met Mr. Augustus Kweku Adams, a fellow student from Krofu near Makesim and Agona Swedu in the central region. They fell in love, got married, and immediately after completing their course in 1963, moved to Agona Swedu to begin their lives together as a couple and as professional teachers. At Agona Swedu, Lucy taught at the Eban B Basic School and worshiped together with her family at the St. Anthony's Roman Catholic Church. In 1964, the couple had their first child, a daughter named Nana Emisa Adams, followed by three other children: Augustus Papa Adams, Esther Mamiajua Adams, and Emmanuel Eko Ampa Adams. After Esther was born in 1970, Lucy went to further her education at the then Winneba Advanced Teacher Training College, returning to Agona Swedu on completing her st- studies. The couple spent 18 memorable years in Sweden until in 1981, when Lucy joined thousands of Ghanaian teachers relocating to Nigeria to seek greener pastures away from the economic hardship emanating from Ghana's failing economy at that time. Lucy taught at the United High School in Lawe Ekiti in the former Ondo State, near now Ekiti State. She moved to Lorain Kwara State in 1985 to continue her teaching career at Agbeyange High School. Lucy worked hard to ensure that her children were well cared for, especially in the times of economic hardship that bedeviled Ghana where they lived. After 10 years in Nigeria, Lucy returned to Ghana in 1991 and continued teaching at Aflawu in the Volta region. She became the headmistress at SS Peter and Paul Junior Secondary in Aflawu until April 2000, when her daughter, Esther, invited her to the United States of America. Lucy then settled with Esther and her family in Atlanta, Georgia, where she lived until her demise. While in Atlanta, she worshiped regularly at the St. Andrew Catholic Church in Roswell. Lucy was loved by everyone, both young and old, at church and in the community. She made lasting and positive impressions on everyone she came across in USA, especially in Atlanta. Due to her kind and loving nature, she was also appreciated for the enduring and excellent pieces of advice she gave freely to everyone she met, especially her nieces, nephews, and grandchildren, for whom she always had words of encouragement. This helped to guide and shape their immediate and future choices. In 2021, Lucy's health started failing gradually, despite several visits to the hospital, during which she received treatment. God finally called her to eternity on the 29th March 2022 in Atlanta, Georgia. Lucy Abla Adams is survived by 4 children and 14 grandchildren and 15 siblings who deeply mourn her loss. May her blessed and gentle soul continue to rest in perfect peace in the bosom of the Lord God. Amen.
Let us all stand for the final commendation. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Lucy, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Lucy again and enjoy her friendship. Although we shall disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Our response is, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let a perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Lucy in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, we will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Lucy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We are now invite the wreath bearers and the pallbearers to please come forward. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Whoever believes in me, even though that person die, shall live. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of the Lord, the Mass is ended.
It's close.